have the pleasure to welcome Axel Lemaire, which is a Minister of State for Digital Affairs. We'll discuss of many things, of course, of Brexit, because I asked her specifically to discuss of that, because many people who were on that stage for the 2 days didn't really want to speak about it for plenty of reasons. So Axel said yes. Just one introduction, one word of introduction, because when I invite political people, especially in France, a year of election, I have some remarks. And I wanted to say that when you launch something as an entrepreneur, we are four in my company, we are a startup, and like many fintech, we need support. When I launched the first edition 1 year and a half ago, the first person, the first one, very first one, who said, yes, we'll support you, was Axel. So this is something I will never forget, so thank you for that. That helped a lot, even if the state, as every European state, they don't have any money, they cannot really give money. But the support of a minister is really important when you go to see sponsor and you say, the minister is with us. That helps a lot. So thank you, Axel, for that. And so my first question is, the impact of Brexit on the fintech sector in Europe. What's your point of view today after what, say, Theresa May last week? So.
Well, first of all, thank you for inviting me. And I think it's great to have a fintech event in Paris. I was really waiting for that initiative to happen. And it always depends on people like you who want to spend their time, money, and energy in organizing such an ambitious event. So congratulations. And I really wish the best to the fintech industry in France and in Europe more generally, because I think there are key assets to put forward in the international competition. So in that context, where does Brexit stand? I don't have any scoop. I've listened, as you've probably done, to Theresa May's speech last week. She confirmed that she was pursuing the hard Brexit option. What does that mean? Probably for the finance industry and the startups working in that industry, that they will no longer have access to the European passport. And so that's one thing. Hence, the initiatives taken by various regulators, including the French regulator, to adapt the regulation framework and their response to fintech requests for authorization to provide services in France, well, to be quicker, more flexible, and I think the regulator was present during the forum, and they announced what they were putting into place. This is really a welcome move, but this is not very digital. This is very welcome move. Because the competition between regulators is fierce.